Tessa Ray Yoga.
Hello, lovely people. Welcome to my channel. My name is Tessa, and today I'm very pleased to be showing you a super mellow practice to help alleviate headaches and also to prevent migraines. Let's get started.
Okay, so there's a lot of shoulder work that we could do that would be helpful for opening up the upper back and the neck, but today we're just going to focus on two things that have really helped me and a lot of my students with tension headaches specifically. Just find yourself in a comfortable seated position. We're going to stretch out our necks. So just letting the right shoulder come up and down a few times, relieving tension in the right side. And left shoulder, same up and down. And then the right shoulder, roll it forward a few times. Big circle. So up, forward, relax, and back. Up, forward, relax, and back. And the other way, forward, up, back. Relax, forward, up, back, relax, backward circles. And deep breath. So starting to breathe in and out through the nose, allowing the breath to deepen, to slow down. Let's go left side, forward circles. So that's up, forward, relax, back. And backward circles, forward, up, back, and relax. Relax the shoulders, relax both shoulders. Looking to the right, and as you turn your head to the right, just be mindful that our shoulders are staying stable, still. Sending your intention, like healing intention, into the left side of the neck and letting go on the exhale. Looking over the left shoulder. And sending your breath, your intention into the area that needs to release and relax the most. And head coming back to center. So now, again, relax the shoulders, keep them still. Let the right ear come to the right shoulder. And so we're not trying to get the ear to the shoulder, actually. We want the right shoulder to be relaxing. We're just going in that direction. And then maybe the left hand can come out beside you, and you're reaching your left fingers and your left ear away from one another as we continue to deep breathe into that stretch. Relax your jaw. Relax your forehead, your eyes. And carefully bringing everything back up. And slowly let the left ear come to the left shoulder without the shoulder moving. And then your right fingers can reach beside you. And we're reaching fingers and right ear away from one another. And again, deep breathing. Relaxing on the exhale. And this is very much about letting go and softening as opposed to going deep or going far or really pushing or forcing a stretch. Be sure to be really focusing on just relaxation. And everything coming back to center. So for this one, we can look up with our eyes. If we're comfortable with it, we can lift the chin, or some of us will be comfortable to let the head go completely back. This is one that we just don't force if it feels iffy. But if the mobility is there, we want to keep that mobility so you can go ahead. I do also like taking both hands behind me and reaching back and leaning the chest forward. We want the shoulders back and down away from the ears. Bringing the head carefully up and the hands back to the lap, chin towards your chest. And the head coming up. This time, left hand comes beside you first, right ear to right shoulder. And if you want to go a little deeper here, we can roll the chin towards the right shoulder. Breathe into your neck and your shoulders and your head. Letting go on the exhale. Everything carefully coming back up. Right hand beside you and left ear to left shoulder. And we can roll the chin carefully to the left shoulder. And everything carefully coming back up when that feels done. So the next pose we're going to be doing is legs up the wall, which I've had really good feedback from people who have migraines regularly. This can be something that is like a preventative practice for migraines, and definitely helpful for people with headaches. Yeah, so great practice. So the best way to get your legs up the wall is to lay on your side. Hopefully you have a little more room than me. Scoot your bum right up against the wall and then lay on your back and put your legs up the wall. And so what's important here is to assess the comfort of your neck and your lower back. Some people have some discomfort in the lower back, so you can lift your bum and put a bit of height underneath your bum. So that could be a pillow, a bolster, a yoga block. If your pelvis is not on the floor or on something solid, you need to move away from the wall until your bum is for sure on the ground. If your bum is hovering, your pelvis is hovering off the ground, it's not going to be great for your lower back after some time. And we're going to be here for a little while. And then same goes with the neck. If you find yourself like having quite a chin lift here, some height under the head so that your neck is in a comfortable position. For me, I'm quite comfortable here, so I am not going to use either of those. And so again, the number one priority, pelvis on the floor or on something solid, bum at the wall would be the next kind of goal from there. And so we've got our pelvis on something solid. We're going to push into our elbows and slide our ribs up and slide our skull up and just lengthen the spine here. And we're going to take our hands onto our belly. So letting the shoulders relax. The shoulders heavy into the floor. And we're going to start to breathe into our hands. So on the inhale, we're going to expand the belly like a balloon. Exhale to draw the belly back to the spine. Inhale, belly expanding. Exhale, belly draws back. And that's it. We are simply belly breathing with our legs up the wall. Continue. So the average person uses only a fraction of their lung capacity. And so we can have stagnant CO2 that builds up in our lungs, which can cause headaches. Also, this line, the superficial back line, when that gets tight, it actually connects from the soles of the feet through the backs of the legs, through the back and into the eyebrows. And so when it gets tight, it can cause tension headaches. So we're kind of, we're doing two things at once here to help with headaches. So just continue with that belly breathing. And as you continue to breathe, you'll find yourself potentially relaxing quite deeply. And so just allowing for that to happen, but do try to stay awake and stay with the practice of breathing in and out of the belly. A nice thing we can incorporate is emptying just a moment longer. When you think you're empty, just empty a little bit more. Next time you exhale, just returning to the natural breath. And if you do feel any discomfort creeping into the lower back or the neck, just go ahead and adjust yourself now. A little bit of height under either of those areas. And then hands coming on to the rib cage. And if your thumbs are able to wrap around, I really like that because then we get something touching the back ribs. And so here I'm thinking of an accordion. I want my shoulders on the floor, my elbows resting, so arms relaxed. And I'm going to inhale my ribs to expand like an accordion. And then contracting as well like an accordion. Continue. Inhale, ribs expanding. Exhale, ribs contracting. So find a pace and a depth of breath that's feeling really good to you today. And by the way, it is normal to feel your legs start to go tingly and numb. So we're just reversing our flow of blood and lymph here. Very, very positive for our health. However, if you do find it overwhelming or distracting, you can just bend your knees and then join back in when you're ready to. As you continue to practice this over time, your tolerance for that sensation will build up. No rush with that. Inhale, ribs expanding. And exhale, ribs contract. So again, we can empty and then empty just a moment longer, squeezing the ribs, emptying. Next time that you exhale, again, natural breathing. And then we're going to combine a bit of a shoulder and neck release with our chest breathing. So we're reaching our arms up. We're going to cross the arms and just let the arms, we can either let the arms hang or grip onto the shoulders. So now we're going to inhale and fill the space underneath our arms. On the inhale, expand the chest. Exhaling to empty that space. Inhale, chest expanding under the arms. And exhale, relax, empty that space. Keep going just like that. And so as we continue with the chest breathing, explore your ability again to empty a little longer. As well as your ability to inhale to fill the upper back, the neck, and the head. So that might be a little bit of imagination there, but same idea where we're bringing intention into the area that we want to feel better, that we want to let go of tension. So inhale to fill chest, upper back, neck, shoulders, head. Exhale, let go, release. Empty a moment longer. And we'll take three more breaths into the upper chest, neck, shoulders. And then natural breathing. And swapping your cross. Other arm on top. Bend your elbows. Grab for the shoulders. Relax the neck and the shoulders. So we're going to combine those three parts into one full breath. Being aware that our number one priority with the breathing is that we're comfortable, we're relaxed. So if you are trying too hard or forcing the breath and causing some forcing or agitation feelings, then you need to ease off a little bit, less effort. Feel free to return just to belly breathing or the ribcage breathing or any part of that breathing that really resonated with you. Otherwise, we're going to combine the three. So we're going to take a cleansing breath together. Big inhale to fill your lungs. It's our only forced breath. Inhale, fill. Exhale, empty. Filling belly. Then ribs. Then chest. Exhale. Belly filling. Ribs, chest, empty. So you'll find a pace that's good for you. Start with just a little bit of effort before you really start to like fill completely. Belly first, ribs, chest, exhale. So continue like that, filling from bottom to top, and then we exhale. filling belly, then the ribs, then the chest, and exhale. And as you continue, I find that it starts to feel really just like a wave moving up the spine and then down the spine. And I do start to imagine the breath, which is healing energy, moving into my head as well. Exhaling to let go of tension. Inhaling that wave of healing energy up the spine into the head. Exhaling to let go. I'm going to take 5 more rounds of breath like that. Returning to your natural breath when your 5 rounds are done. And slowly releasing the arms, just let the arms rest beside you in a comfortable place. Wake up your feet a little bit with a flex and point, might feel very weird, and that is okay. Just do a couple ankle circles. And then other way. And so we want to come out of this position gradually, just to give our circulation a chance to recover. So I like to just bend my knees for a moment. And then rolling onto your side, using your arm to support your head. And feel free to stay here for as long as you like while you feel the sensation and blood coming back into your legs. And I do have another video for slouching that would go really well if you feel like you want to continue to stretch out your shoulders and your upper back. I hope you're feeling better and enjoy your day.
I so hope that you are feeling some relief from that practice today. If you enjoyed it, please give the video a like. And if you would like to continue to support free yoga on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me today and for allowing me to share my practice with you. Namaste.